Now that the new and improved Bill Gates has dominated the headlines for years, many people have forgotten about the accusations of stealing ideas from others in your industry and then relentlessly using intellectual property laws against anyone who threatened your dominance. Your reputation was at its worst when Microsoft was caught up in an antitrust legal battle with the United States government, because you spent years developing a tech monopoly through your company. In 2001, Microsoft was forced to settle with the government and give up its monopoly of the industry, and the next year, you began shifting your time, and more importantly, your money, into the pharmaceutical industry. This time around, you have come to dominate an industry as an outsider, through stock investments and charitable organizations that are not bound to the same regulations as a publicly traded company. There is no doubt that advancing medicine is a noble cause, and it is true that investments in public health are important, but not everyone involved in the pharmaceutical industry actually has the best interests of the public in mind. As with any industry, it all comes down to the almighty dollar. There are some people in the industry who have good intentions, but judging by your track record at Microsoft, you are not someone who can be trusted. And let's not forget that just months ago, you were in the news because your relationship with the disgraced human trafficker Jeffrey Epstein was being exposed. Now, as frightened people around the world are demanding solutions and looking to people like you for answers, you have advocated for some extremely draconian measures, including a surveillance system to track down anyone who might be infected. Of course, all of this sounds like a necessary step in a global pandemic, and this virus is a very real threat. But in China and other places where these measures have been implemented, human rights violations followed quickly after. It is also very strange that for many years, your companies and foundations have been heavily involved in a project called ID 2020, something that seems very similar to the systems you have proposed in recent interviews. You may own the corporate media, but we still have the internet, and you will be exposed. We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget.